eat or what ye shall drink, yet your body for your body, what ye shall put on, is not the life more than meat, and the body more than raiment? To some men, giving up dressing in fashionable style is worth more than going to church. Going out to a fine restaurant and paying $300 on the tab for a bill is worth more than going to church and tithing and giving off.
Yes, sir.
Verse number 26, behold the fowls of the air, for they sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns, and yet your heavenly Father feedeth them. Are not ye much better than they? Birds don't worry, and they are fed every day. Which of you, by taking thought, can add one cubic unto your stature? Worry doesn't add to your growth, not a bit. And why take ye thought for raiment? Consider the lilies of the field, for they grow and they toil not, neither do they spin. For yet I say unto you that even Solomon in all of his glory was not arrayed like one of these. These lilies of the field look better than Solomon. And boy, when you read how Solomon dressed with all that purple and linen, Claude Chuck Swindoll teaches a story about Solomon. He says Solomon was tall and black, and he was handsome, had dark skin, and he loved to dress in white linen. And he would dress in white linen, and his hair was long locks, black like raven feathers. It takes Chuck Swindoll to describe Solomon. And he says he had makeup people. He was so rich. He went out for a morning drive about 5 o'clock every morning with his Arabian horses and chariots. But he had makeup people to make sure he was dressed before the king came out to public. And so he was tall and black, and he had long black hair, and his makeup people would sprinkle like salt, gold dust powder in his hair. And he would dress up to his neck in his white. And they would escort him out, his entourage, to get up on his chariot and say where he stood was gold, pure gold, that was surrounded with purple. His wheels were gold, blades were silver, his horses were imported from Arabia, the fastest of horses, and he would have an entourage of about 100, 150, 200 that would go out on the morning ride every morning. They would strike out and go across the flats of the desert, and his riders would be along with him. They'd get to the destination point, turn to come back. And so Solomon would always look back, pop his Arabian horses and run off and leave everybody. And by the time he was coming back, the peak of the sun was coming over the horizon that would hit Solomon's hair with that gold sprinkle in it, and it looked like his hair lit up like the sky. So ride on, brother.